Animals can crossbreed with each other and result in making the most unusual specimens we humans would ever see. These guys are literally a once-in-a-lifetime thing to witness. Today, we'll take a look at some of the few animal hybrids that actually exist. Welcome to Animals Wow TV. Let's get started. We begin this list with the most unusual-sounding hybrid animal, the Wolfen. One of the rarest hybrid creatures is the Wolfen. They're the result of a female bottlenose dolphin mating with a male false killer whale. Wolfins are a fascinating combination of their parents. Their skin is dark gray, like a cross between light gray dolphin skin and black fake killer whale skin. They also have 66 teeth, which is the exact average of the 88 teeth of dolphins and the 44 teeth of the fake killer whale. Although citizen wolfin sightings in the wild are prevalent, scientists have yet to find substantial proof. We can only view them reliably in captivity right now. As I mentioned previously, this is a liger, the cousin of the tigon we looked at before. The liger, which is the offspring of a male lion and a female tiger, is the most well-known hybrid animal and the biggest of the big cats. Ligers are frequently significantly larger than their parents. The world's largest non-obese liger weighs 1,000 pounds, whereas the heaviest one ever recorded weighed 1,600. Because lions and tigers do not normally occupy the same regions, ligers would be almost hard to locate in the wild, unlike certain other hybrid creatures. They resemble lions more than tigers in appearance and behavior, but they do have tiger characteristics such as a love of swimming and striped backs. Forget about tigons, wolfins, and ligers. At the farm, where cross-species hybrids are more prevalent than you may expect, there are plenty of jaw-dropping hybrids to be had. The Zubron, a hybrid between cows and wisent, must be mentioned. Oh, and what exactly is a wisent, wise guy? Those are European wood bison, which was previously on the verge of extinction, but are now on the verge of return, owing to reintroduction efforts. Zubron is basically Europe's version of beefalo. Buffalo. Waffle. You get the ideas. Hybrid videos, man. Let's return to big cats for a while. This is a leopon, which is the offspring of a male leopard and a female lion. The animal's head resembles that of a lion, but the remainder of its body resembles that of a leopard. Leopons are bigger than leopards and have attributes of both the leopard and the lion, according to research from Japanese cats. Their patches are brown rather than black, and their tails are tufted. They'll climb like leopards and appear to appreciate water as much as leopards do. A Geep, a goat-sheep hybrid, is so uncommon that it only makes the headlines once every 10 years. Despite its beautiful appearance, the Geep is quite uncommon. Some specialists question whether the Geep is a real hybrid or merely a sheep with genetic flaws. Cross-species conception is almost difficult since goats and sheep have different numbers of chromosomes. If this occurs, only a small percentage of kids are brought to term, and even fewer survive delivery. The Kama, like the beefalo, was developed to produce a more commercially viable animal than either of its parents. Kamas are dromedary camels and llama hybrids produced through artificial insemination. Because male dromedary camels may weigh 6 times more than female llamas, and reverse breeding is ineffective. This is the best and safest way to breed them, because that must be one tall tree to climb. Wink, wink. Kamas lack camel humps and have silky, fleecy hair akin to that of llamas. They were designed to produce mega wool and be robust and docile enough to be utilized as a pack animal in arid regions. Savannah cats are exotic hybrids created by crossing a domestic cat with a wild African serval. They're home pets, but they're also exotic hybrids. Savannas are giant cats that are similar in size to large domestic cats. Their spotted coats, towering frames, and thin proportions give them a wild exotic appearance. Savannah cats with a higher proportion of serval blood can grow to be double the size of a domestic cat. Anyone interested in acquiring one should conduct an extensive study before making a purchase. A more common hybrid animal that you might know as hybrid is a mule. Mules are the offspring of a horse mare and a donkey jack that were bred together. Hinnies, the outcome of mating between a donkey Jenny and a horse stallion, are less common. Mules are believed to have hybrid vitality, and fans feel that they have the best of both species' characteristics. This is a zonkey, another member of the zebroids family. A zonkey is a cross between a zebra and a donkey that results from mating. Because they have an odd number of chromosomes and are unable to breed, zonkeys are not considered real species. Zonkeys are bred in a variety of zoos and specialist farms across the world, despite their rarity. Depending on who's breeding them and what mix of donkey and zebra species is being utilized, zonkeys are also known as zebonkeys, zebrinis, zebrulas, zebedonks, hazuzas, zebuzzabuzz, and a variety of other names. Okay, I threw those last two in there because I was having fun with all the zuzas and the zazus. Would you believe me if I told you that wolves and coyotes can also be intimate lovers? Well, this is the result of that forsaken relationship, and it's called a coy wolf. These canine hybrids, which have DNA from coyotes, wolves, and even domestic dogs, exist through a broad expanse of northern North America. Coyote-wolf hybrids were initially discovered in the early 20th century and have the ability to breed effectively over generations. These guys have become a fairly common animal, and like zebroids, they come in a variety of colors and sizes, but they all have the same name. A male dzo is a cross between a yak and a domesticated cow. A dzomo is a female offspring. It's known as a hainag in Mongolian. They are bigger and stronger than cattle or yaks because they are the result of the hybrid genetic phenomena called heterosis. Their function in Central Asian agriculture is remarkably similar to that of the mule, which is utilized for heavy lugging and plowing in the West. Because plowing is what these animals did to make this little hybrid. Giggity giggity, giggity giggity. Next in line, we have the Mallard Ducks, which are hybrids of different sorts of ducks all mashed together. They are very hard to distinguish from normal ducks because they crazily look the same as them, but there are a few key features that help in setting them apart. A hybrid male Mallard X American Black Duck, for example, may be easily distinguished. They have a similar appearance to the American Black Duck, but with a Mallard green head. Alright, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed what you saw. Do smash that like button if this video was to your liking. Comment down below which animal hybrid you think is the most unique. Subscribe to our channel if this is the sort of video that you like to watch. See you all in the next video. Thanks for watching, and take care.